So guys, I'm here in El Socorro, and I'm here at the home of Mr. Zahir Ali. And this is the Glimmer of Hope Foundation. Mr. Zahir Ali.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Now, give me the backstory. Glimmer of Hope seems as though there's a lot of elements involved. So tell me the backstory on how this...
Glimmer of Hope came about 3 years ago. As a cancer patient wanting to help back families, I went to a home with a plastic bag to give to that child with some snacks. And when that child took that bag, that child started to cry. When she brought her bag, school bag, was a plastic bag. Right. So she did not want what was inside the bag. She wanted a bag to put her books in.
Right.
Today that child is in SANS Form 3, and this is where we are today.
That's very good. Now, in terms of stakeholders, right? People have seen you on Facebook, etc. How has the reception been in terms of stakeholders and sponsors?
Overwhelming. In fact, this year alone, we were able to fill 178 book lists.
Wow.
Complete book lists. Right now, we are doing our drive for Bahamas, and also we are doing our monthly drive with 36 hampers per families.
So is it just for the El Socorro community, or have you spanned far-wide in terms of...
Just last 2 weeks, we were able to venture to Guyana. To help a child with cerebral palsy in Guyana also.
Right.
So long there is a need, an eligible need, we do proper assessment first and foremost.
Right.
That is why people want to help, but they want to make sure when they give, it goes to family in need.
Yeah.
And at the same time, we empower and enrich families to get out of the situation they are in.
So the greatest challenge you would say in the past 3 years has been what?
Challenges such as, I would not say we had any challenges as such, because the support has been overwhelming.
Okay.
We have a wonderful team of directors and members. In fact, in every area in Trinidad and Tobago, we have a member.
Right.
So when they cannot get me, you call somebody in Grand, you get through. So our whole organization is running smoothly, I must say, with no hiccups.
Okay. Now, everybody would see this story. Some people will be inspired. And some may not do anything. Some may be inspired and say, I'm going to take action. But they may not know what to do. Can you give some advice in terms of lessons learned or steps that you need to take to start something like this in the community?
I never thought today I would have been doing this as a humanitarian.
Yeah.
I never thought today I would have been able to, for the past 3 years, we have built over 27 homes.
Right.
What it takes is a heart and a love for humanity. Regardless of race, religion, creed, sex, whatever it may be, someone reaches out to you, you should be able to extend your hand back to them.
Yes.
Yes. So it does not matter if race or religion, I believe, so long as you have a love for humanity and a love for our citizens, I think anybody can do this. It don't take much.
That's very true. So, Mr. Ali, where do you see yourself in the next 5 to 10 years?
I see myself where I am, and as I say, whatever God has in store for me, we will get there. I believe right now God say, you know, this is what he have for you. You can handle this amount alone. Do not put your hat where you carry it.
Yeah.
If God say the next 3 years we'll have a big building, God be with it.
Yeah.
But right now, we happy where we are. And whatever the Lord have for us in the future, we will accept all the challenges with it.
Very good.
God bless you.
Mr. Zahir Ali, one of our court's hero nominees, doing some great work in El Socorro and also throughout the Caribbean. So we'll look out for him very soon. Thank you.